奉主耶稣圣名在这里一起来学习。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we are gathered to learn together here.
好，请看约翰福音第五章。
Let's turn to the book of John, chapter 5.
第一节到第九节。
Verses 1-9.
约翰福音第五章一到九节。
John chapter 5, verses 1-9.
五章第一节。
Chapter 5, verse 1.
这事以后，到了犹太人的一个节期，耶稣就上耶路撒冷去。第二节。
2.
在耶路撒冷靠近羊门有一个池子，希伯来话叫做毕士大，旁边有五个廊子。第三节。
3.
里面躺着瞎眼的、瘸腿的、血气枯干的，许多的病人，有古卷在此，有等候水洞。第四节。
4.
因为有天使按时下池子搅动那水，水洞之后谁先下去，无论害什么病就痊愈了。第五节。
5.
在那里有一个人病了38年。第六节。
6.
耶稣看见他躺着，知道他病了许久，就问他说，你要痊愈吗？第七节。
7.
病人回答说，先生，水洞的时候没有人把我放在池子里，我正去的时候就有别人比我先下去。第八节。
8.
耶稣对他说，起来拿着你的褥子走吧。第九节。
9.
那人立刻痊愈，就拿起褥子来走了。各位弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
Peace be to all our beloved brothers and sisters.
很高兴有机会来到我们San Jose教会，跟大家一起来学习。
I am very glad to have the opportunity to come to San Jose Church to learn with everyone.
好，今天早上小弟就想用这一段圣经一起来学习怜悯的道理。
And this morning, I would like to use this passage in the Bible to learn of the topic of mercy.
这一段圣经是约翰福音所记载主耶稣所行的第三个神迹呀。
This passage records the third miracle that Jesus performed in the book of John.
在约翰福音里面记载主耶稣所行的神迹总共只有七件。
In the book of John, there were recordings of about 7 miracles.
而每一件神迹都好像是一个记号一样。
And every miracle seems to be like a sign.
具有特别的意义了。
There contains specific special meaning.
第一个神迹是迦拿的筵席。
The first miracle was the banquet at Cana.
告诉我们，我们要跟主耶稣建立亲密的关系，必须从家庭做起。
Tells us that in order to have an intimate relationship with our Lord, it must start from the family.
要把主耶稣接到我们的家中。
And we must welcome and invite Jesus into our home.
让主耶稣成为我们一家之主。
So that the Lord can become the head of our house.
并且要尊主为大。
And we must also view him as being the greatest.
那第二个神迹是医治大臣的儿子。
The second miracle is of the healing of the son.
这个主题是当信主的话。
And the topic of this is to believe in the word of God.
告诉我们，相信主的话是我们信仰的根基呀。
To tell us that if we believe in the word of God, that will be the root and foundation of our faith.
更是我们跟主耶稣建立关系的基础。
And it is also the way that we build up our relationship with our Lord.
我们只有相信主的话，我们才能够蒙主喜悦的。
Only in believing in the word of God will we be pleased in His eyes.
才能够得到主的恩典。
And only in that way will we receive His blessings.
最后才能得着新的生命。
And in the end, we will be able to receive a new life.
今天早上我们要来谈一谈第三个神迹。
This morning, we will talk about the third miracle.
就是主耶稣医治了一个38年的瘸子。
Which is the healing of a man who has been unable to walk for 38 years.
这件神迹是发生在犹太人的一个节期呀。
And this miracle happened on a festival of the Jews.
这个节期到底是什么节期呢？
And what is this particular festival?
圣经没有很清楚的记载。
The Bible does not specifically specify.
一般认为很可能是五旬节。
Most people believe that it could possibly be the Pentecost.
不过也有人认为应该是逾越节。
But some also believe that it might be another festival.
但是不管怎么样，这个节期一定是犹太人的三大节期之一。
But regardless, it should be one of the main feasts of the Jews.
一定相当重要。
So it is of importance.
所以主耶稣才要到耶路撒冷去过节。
And that is why Jesus went to Jerusalem to to observe the feast.
而当主耶稣到达耶路撒冷之后啊，
and after Jesus arrived at Jerusalem,
就在耶路撒冷北边靠近羊门的那个地方，
there was a area called the Sheep Gate, which is on the north side.
有一个人造的池子啊。
There was a man-made pool.
希伯来话叫做毕士大池。
And in Hebrew, it is called the pool at Bethesda.
这个毕士大翻出来就是怜悯之家的意思啊。
And the translation means the pool of mercy.
所以我们才用这个主题来彼此勉励啊。
And that is why we use this topic as mutual encouragement.
啊，这个池子，考古学家在耶路撒冷已经发掘出来了。
And this pool has been found by archaeologists.
是一个人工造的蓄水池。
It is a man-made pool.
啊，在现在毕士大区圣安妮教堂的地下。
And it is underground, below the chapel at Bethesda.
那么，因为这个地方地势比较高。
Because the land on this, in this area is higher.
所以它的水源很可能不是山泉呢。
So it could be most likely that the source of the water is not from the mountains.
而是雨季下雨的时候的临时蓄水池。
It could be a pool gathered after the rain.
所以不常有泉水进来。
So it is not often streams of water comes flowing in.
因此只要有泉水一冒出来，那就是千载难逢的好机会啊。
And when there are springs that arise from it, then it is a very great opportunity.
啊，于是大家争着要下去。
So people would hurry to try to go in.
据说这是天使按时下来搅动泉水。
And according to what they believed, it is angels coming down to stir the water.
所以只要水一动，不管谁先下去，他不管患什么病，就都能够得到痊愈啊。
So when the water moves and the first person in the pool, no matter what disease that person has, it will be healed.
那这个池子相当大。
And this pool is quite large.
长有96公尺。
It's about 96 meters.
那宽是67到50公尺啊。
And that's about the width is about 67 to 50 meters.
啊，中间隔开分成两边。
And then there's a division in between, so there are two areas.
那池的四边各有根柱子。
And amongst the four surroundings of the pool, there's a post.
它中间隔开的地方也有一根柱子。
There's also another porch in the middle of the pool.
因此，圣经说在这个池子的旁边有五个廊子。
That is why the Bible says there are five porches around the pool.
啊，里面躺满了许多的病人呢。
And within it, it has many. There are many illness people with illnesses.
有瞎眼的。
There are people who are blind.
有瘸腿的。
The lame.
有血气枯干的。
The paralyzed.
啊，这些病人都在那里等候水动的时候。
And all these sick people are there awaiting for the movement of the water.
看看能不能抢第一个下去。
Hoping to be the first to get in.
让自己的病得到痊愈。
So that their illness can be healed.
是的。
It's true.
生病的人非常不幸。
It is unfortunate when a person is sick.
生病的人非常可怜啊。
And it is very pitiful when a person is sick.
他不只是他自己痛苦啊，连他的亲人也要跟着他受痛苦。
Not only are they the ones that are suffering, but their surrounding relatives are also suffering.
所以病人最大的盼望是什么？
So what is the greatest hope for a sick person?
就是希望自己的病能够得到痊愈啊。
It is to hope that they can be recovered of their sin, of their sickness.
就在这个时候，那里有一个人哦。
At this one particular time, there was a certain person.
他是瘸腿的。
And he was lame.
他瘸腿已经38年。
He had an infirmity for 38 years.
虽然圣经没有记载他当时到底几岁啊。
Although the Bible does not record what age this person is.
但是根据判断，很可能他一生下来就瘸腿了。
But according to speculation, it could be very well aware that he was born this way.
他躺在床上不能起来已经将近40年了。
He was unable to walk and had to be laid in bed for about close to 40 years.
啊，这是相当痛苦的一件事情。
This is a very great suffering.
啊，今天有的人生病只有躺一星期他就受不了。
Some of us who are sick might just have to lay in bed for 1 week and it is already hard to take.
这个人却躺了将近40年。
This person had to lay in bed for close to 40 years.
他没有行动的自由。
He has no ability to walk.
他每天都需要别人来伺候。
He needs people to serve him.
他身上的肌肉很可能因为长期没有动，已经萎缩了。
Could be that his muscles are no longer functioning because of the lack of movement.
啊，他的前途真的暗淡无光。
His future is really dim.
那在这种情况底下，他不敢希望什么。
So under this kind of situation, circumstance, he does not hope to wish for anything.
他唯一的希望就是我的病能够好。
The only hope he has is to be healed of his sickness.
于是他每天的工作就是在毕士大池旁边痴痴的等。
So his daily task is to wait beside the Bethesda pool to wait.
或许他已经等了三十几年了。
It could be that he waited for over three decades.
但是一次又一次让他很失望。
But time after time, he has been disappointed.
让他的肉体、心灵的忧伤越来越沉重了。
So that his burden and his hopelessness in his heart is heavier.
最后他几乎到了绝望的地步了。
In the end, up to the point of despair.
可是又有谁能够知道他的痛苦呢？
But who is it that would know his true suffering?
又有谁能了解他的忧伤呢？
Who really knows his grief?
感谢主。
Thank God.
就在这个时候，主耶稣来了。
At this particular moment, Jesus arrived.
主耶稣看见他的，知道他的痛苦。
Jesus saw his illness.
主耶稣看见他躺着。
Jesus saw him laying there.
知道他病了很久。
Knew that he has been sick for a long time.
主耶稣知道他很忧伤。
And Jesus knew that he was grieved.
因为主耶稣是神啊。
Because Jesus is God.
他知道万人的心啊。
He knows the heart of all men.
请看约翰福音第二章。
Let's turn to John chapter 2.
24节。
Verse 24.
约翰福音第二章24节。
John chapter 2 verse 24.
二章的24节。
2:24.
耶稣却不将自己交托他们，因为他知道万人。二十五节
25.
也用不着谁见证人怎样，因他知道人心里所存的。
24. But Jesus did not commit himself to them because he knew all men. 25. And had no need that anyone should testify of men, for he knew what was in man.
啊，主耶稣知道万人的心啊。
So Jesus knew the hearts of all men.
所以人不必讲。
So there is no need to say anything.
主耶稣都知道的。
Because Jesus knows.
包括人一切的痛苦，一切的忧伤。
Including all the sufferings and troubles a person has.
啊，不但是这样，主耶稣更了解他现在最需要的是什么。
Not only that, Jesus furthermore understands what he really needs at this point.
因为主耶稣是怜悯人的主啊。
Because Jesus is a merciful God.
请看马太福音。
Let's turn to Matthew.
第九章。
Chapter 9.
马太福音第九章。
Matthew chapter 9.
三十五节。
Verse 35.
马太福音第九章三十五节。
Matthew chapter 9 verse 35.
耶稣走遍各城各乡，在会堂里教训人，宣讲天国的福音，又医治各样的病症。三十六节。
36.
他看见许多的人，就怜悯他们，因为他们困苦流离，如同羊没有牧人一般。
35. Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. But when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion for them, because they were weary and scattered, like sheep having no shepherd.
我们再请看第十四章。
Let's continue on to chapter 14.
十四章十四节。
Chapter 14, verse 14.
马太福音十四章的十四节。
Matthew 14 verse 14.
耶稣出来，见有许多的人，就怜悯他们，治好了他们的病人。
And when Jesus went out, he saw a great multitude, and he was moved with compassion for them and healed their sick.
当主耶稣在世上传福音的时候
，When Jesus was preaching in the world,
主耶稣医治了许多的病人呢。
Jesus healed many sick, those many ill people who are sick.
为什么？
Why is that?
除了要证明他就是那个要来的弥赛亚以外
，aside from proving that he was the Messiah，
更重要的是因为主耶稣知道这些人的痛苦。
More importantly, it was so that Jesus, because Jesus knew the sufferings of these people，
了解这些人的需要。
He understood what these people needed.
因为主耶稣可怜他们啊。
Jesus had compassion on them.
因为主耶稣关心他们呐。
Jesus cared for them.
所以主耶稣才主动怜悯他们。
That is why Jesus, out of compassion,
白白医治他们。
Cured them.
因此雅各长老才这样说。
And that is why Jacob once said.
雅各，请看雅各书第五章。
Let's turn to James.
雅各书第五章。
Book of James, chapter 5.
请看十一节。
James chapter 5, verse 11.
雅各书第五章十一节。
James chapter 5, verse 11.
五章十一节。
5, 11.
那先前忍耐的人，我们称他们是有福的。你们听见过约伯的忍耐，也知道主给他的结局，明显主是满心怜悯，大有慈悲的。
Indeed, we count them blessed who endure.You have heard of the perseverance of Job and seen the end intended by the Lord, that the Lord is very compassionate and merciful.
雅各长老很肯定地告诉我们，我们所信的主是满心怜悯、大有慈悲的主。
Elder James tells us very clearly that the Lord we believe in is full of compassion and mercy.
这个就是主耶稣的爱。
This is the love of our Lord Jesus.
也是主耶稣爱我们最具体的表现。
This is also his representation of his love.
好，现在怜悯的主到了怜悯之家了。
So now the merciful Lord came to this merciful house.
他动了怜悯的心肠。
And he had shown his merciful heart.
于是主耶稣问这个病人说：“你要痊愈吗？”
So that's Jesus asked this person, "Do you wish to be made well?"
这个问题的答案很简单。
And the answer to this question is very simple.
当然是要啊。
Of course it is yes.
要不然我为什么每天辛辛苦苦到这里来做什么？
Otherwise, why would I have to come here every day to sit here?
啊，又不是来看热闹。
It is not to just watch the people.
都是一些生病的人，也没有什么好看的啦。
There's really not much to see because everyone is sick.
但是问题是药有什么用呢？
But what can I do?
我根本得不到啊。
I cannot receive it.
所以虽然答案很简单，但是我们看到这位病人的回答却有一点点复杂。
So although the answer is very simple, but we can see that the answer of the sick man is a little bit complex.
他的回答不只是表示自己的无奈啊。
His answer does not only show his inability.
啊，同时也显露出人性的自私啊。
But it also shows the selfish.Kind of nature, kind of a person.
他说：“先生啊。”
And he said, he says, Mister.
当水动的时候，没有人把我放在池子里头。
That when the pool moves, no one puts me in the water.
我自己又不能动啊。
And I am unable to move myself.
我需要别人的帮忙。
I need people to help.
可是却没有人愿意来帮助我。
But nobody is willing to help me.
于是我只好自己拼命地爬。
And I have to crawl on my own.
想办法爬下去。
To try to crawl into the pool.
只可惜我的动作太慢，因为我是瘸腿啊。
But unfortunately, I am too slow because I am lame.
总是慢了一步啊。
I am always a step behind.
每一次当我要下去的时候，就有别人比我先下去了。
Every time when I'm about to step in, a person goes in ahead of me.
您说我该怎么办？
So let me ask you, what should I do?
靠别人靠不住啊。
I cannot rely on other people.
靠自己又没办法。
If I rely on myself, I have no ability.
所以他对自己感到非常的无奈哦。
So he felt helpless.
同时也觉得别人实在太自私了一点吧。
And he also felt that others are a bit selfish.
啊，至少也该轮流一下哦。
We should just all take rotations.
至少也该可怜可怜我这个已经38年的瘸子啊。
They should have some pity on me who have been lame for 38 years.
至少也应该给我一次机会才对的啊。
At least give me an opportunity.
但问题是根本没有人会为他着想的。
But the problem is no one will care to think for him.
更没有人愿意为他做这些事情。
And no one is willing to do this for him.
这就是人啊。
This is human nature.
人总是自私的。
Humans are selfish.
人如果有怜悯，也是在很有限的。
And those who have compassion are usually limited.
人很少会站在别人的立场替别人着想。
They very rarely stand in the position of other people to think for others.
总是想到自己的利益啊。
They often always think for themselves.
就算是在怜悯之家也一样啊。
Even at the pool of mercy, it is the same.
没有办法得到真正的怜悯哦。
They do not really truly receive true mercy.
除非有一天自己亲自遇到同样的患难，他才能够感同身受啊。
Unless they themselves encounter the same difficulty, will they realize this?
这就是人哦。
This is human.
听说有一个真实的故事这样说。
I heard of a true story once.
说有一次有一个小孩子到卖狗的狗店去买小狗啊。
That there was once a little child who went into a pet store to purchase a puppy.
他问老板说：“老板，一只多少钱呢？”
So this child asked the owner, "How much is the puppy?"
老板说：“一只50块美金呢。”
And the owner replied, "It is $50."
啊，这个小孩子摸摸口袋，发现他的钱不够啊。
And this little child put his hand in his pocket and realized he did not have enough money.
于是他就回去了。
So he went home.
他回去开始去打工哦。
And he started to work.
存钱了。
To save up.
为了买一只小狗。
In order to buy this little puppy.
几个月以后。
A few months later.
这个小孩子回来买了。
This child came back to the store.
不过他竟然是选上了一只瘸腿的小狗。
But he actually picked a puppy that was crippled.
这个老板觉得很奇怪、啊、
And this owner felt strange.
店里面很多都是好好的不买，为什么偏偏要选这一只瘸腿的呢？
There are a lot of puppies to choose from that are well. Why did this child pick this one that's crippled?
这个老板非常疑惑，不能明白。
So, this owner could not understand.
可是等到这个孩子走出了他的店了。
But when the child left the store.
这个时候老板才恍然大悟，原来如此。
Then the owner realized.
原来这个孩子自己也是瘸腿的。
And noticed that the child himself was crippled.
这就叫做同理心啊。
This is having the same kind of heart.
至少这个小孩他懂得要同病相怜呢。
Because this child knew how to have compassion on others.
至少他还懂得要相依为命啊。
He knew how to hold on to somebody who can help him.
但很可惜的是，事实上在怜悯之家里面，我们所看到的却不一样哦。
But unfortunately, at the pool of mercy, this is not the situation we see.
在怜悯之家里面，竟然没有怜悯哦。
We see here that at this pool, there was no mercy.
请问这不是一个很大的讽刺吗？
Let me ask, isn't this an irony?
没有怜悯就不会有爱心的。
If there's no mercy, there's no love.
没有怜悯就不肯牺牲自己的。
If there's no mercy, you will not self-sacrifice.
没有怜悯就不可能伸出援手的。
If there's no mercy, you will not reach out your hand.
即使是动一动手指也不愿意的。
And you will be unwilling to even move a couple of fingers.
没有怜悯对别人很可能只有苛责。
And if there's no mercy, you will just probably despise others.
很可能只有论断啦。
You probably will just criticize.
就像当时的法利赛人一样。
Just like the Pharisees at that time.
所关心的不是这个人的病啊。
Because they did not really show concern for the illness.
而是这个人为什么在安息日医病。
They cared about why this person healed on the Sabbath day.
尤其是对自己没有什么关系的人更会这样哦。
They will feel even so for to others that they have no relations with.
啊，虽然说同是亚伯拉罕的后裔啦。
Although all of us are the descendants of Abraham.
啊，虽然说我们同样都是敬拜独一真神啦。
Although all of us worship the one true God.
啊，虽然彼此之间也互称弟兄姐妹啦。
Although we all call each other brothers and sisters.
但是毕竟没有很亲的血缘关系啊。
But evidently we do not have that close tie.
所以我没有理由要关心他啊。
So there's no reason for me to care for that person.
我没有必要要怜悯他。
Why should I have mercy on that person?
这就是人的自私啊。
This is the selfishness of humankind.
那么在这种情况底下，请问这个瘸腿的病人还会有希望吗？
So under this kind of situation, does this person have any hope?
当然没有了。
Of course not.
还好这个时候主耶稣来了。
So the good thing is that Jesus arrived.
主耶稣来了就有希望了。
So Jesus gave him hope.
因为主耶稣看到他就怜悯他了。
Because Jesus saw him and had compassion on him.
不为什么的。
Without any asking of why.
只因为主耶稣知道他的痛苦。
It's only because he knew this person's sufferings.
只因为主耶稣了解他的需要。
Only because Jesus knew what this person needed.
只因为主耶稣他真的是爱他。
It is only because Jesus truly loved him.
于是主耶稣对他说。
So Jesus said to him,
起来
Rise.
拿着你的褥子走吧
Take up your bed and walk.
感谢主了
Thank God.
那个人的病立刻就好了
The man was immediately cured.
他真的就起来了
He took his bed and walked.
他真的拿着褥子就走了
He got up and he walked.
走回家去了
He walked home.
他这个神迹就这样圆满的结束了
So this miracle concluded very well.
我们看到这个病人的问题，因着主耶稣的怜悯，他真的得到解决了。
We see that this sick man was cured because of the mercy of God of Jesus.
他的痛苦真的得到释放了。
And he was released of his sufferings.
啊，这是一件值得大家很高兴的事情啊。
This is something that is worthy for people to be joyful about.
只可惜我们看到后来法利赛人不但不高兴，反而要逼迫主耶稣。
But unfortunately, later on, we see that the Pharisees were not only unhappy, but they wanted to persecute Jesus.
请看回来约翰福音第五章。
Let's turn back to John chapter 5.
请看回来约翰福音第五章。
John chapter 5.
第十节。
Verse 10.
五章第十节。
Chapter 5 verse 10.
那天是安息日，所以犹太人对那医好的人说，今天是安息日，你拿着褥子是不可以的。跳过去看十六节。
Let's skip over to verse 16.
第十六节。
Verse 16.
所以犹太人逼迫耶稣，因为他在安息日做了这事。我们看到法利赛人认为主耶稣干犯了安息日。
So we see that the Pharisees saw that Jesus was doing unlawful things on the Sabbath.
所以他们要逼迫主耶稣。
So they wanted to persecute Jesus.
为什么会这样
？Why is this so？
因为他们根本没有怜悯人的心肠啊。
Because they did not have any compassion in their heart.
所以他们根本不能明白主耶稣所做这件事的意义是什么。
So they had not realize at all what the true meaning is of Jesus doing all this.
其实主耶稣不但没有干犯安息日，而且更进一步成全的安息日啊。
But actually, Jesus was not unlawful, but actually fulfilled what should have happened on the Sabbath.
让人不但不必再受旧约律法安息日种种规条的束缚。
So that a person does not have to be held accountable for the laws of the Old Testament.
反而让我们因为守安息日而得到神更大的恩典。
But that to observe the Sabbath, we can be greatly blessed by the Lord.
其实主耶稣是要用怜悯来弥补律法的不足。
But Jesus actually wanted to use compassion to cover up some of the flaws of the laws in the Old Testament.
这就是主耶稣来到世上的目的啊。
And this is the reason why Jesus came to the world.
因此主耶稣才说。
And that is why Jesus said.
请看第七节。
Let's read verse 7.
约翰福音第五章第七节。
John chapter 5 verse 7.
十七节。
Verse 17.
五章十七节。
Chapter 5 verse 17.
耶稣就对他们说：“我父做事，直到如今，我也做事了。”
But Jesus answered them, "My Father has been working until now, and I have been working."
意思就是说，主耶稣来到世上所做的事，其实是根据天父一向所做的事来做的。
Which means that all that he has been doing is in accordance with what the Father has been doing until now.
并且主耶稣所做的事是继续做天父一向一直在做的事。
So what Jesus is doing is a continuation of what the Father has been doing all throughout.
那么问题是，神一直做到如今的事情到底是什么呢
？The question is, what is this work that he is doing?
最主要有两个哦。
There are two key factors.
第一个。
The first.
虽然人犯罪
，although a person sinned，
但是神还是用他的能力托住这个世界哦。
But God still uses His power to hold on and pull onto this world.
让我们今天能够继续活下去。
So that we can continue to live.
第二个。
Second,
因为人犯罪
，because a person sinned，
所以神用他的慈爱开始展开他救赎的计划。
God uses His compassion to show and reveal the true salvation that He had installed.
从亚当犯罪那个时候就开始。
It started from when Adam sinned.
一直到现在啊。
All the way till now.
神继续做这个工作。
God continues with this work.
啊，这两件大事都是天父一直在做的事情啊。
These two things have been done by our Father.
而且都是因着神的怜悯才有的。
And it only happened because of the compassion that He has.
请问不是这样吗
Let me ask, is this not so?
今天主耶稣就是用神这种怜悯的心肠才来到世界上的。
It is because of this compassion heart that Jesus was able to come to the world.
否则主耶稣根本不需要来的。
Or else he had no reason to come.
为的就是要完成神怜悯人的工作。
The purpose was to fulfill this work of compassion.
主耶稣不只是要怜悯人的肉体。
Not only did he have mercy on our soul,
更要怜悯人的灵魂啊。
But also on our souls.
主耶稣不只是要解决人肉体的痛苦啊。
Not only did he want to relieve us of our sufferings in our physical body,
更要解决我们灵魂的痛苦。
But also to help us and with our souls.
那所不同的是什么？
And what is the difference?
要解决人肉体的痛苦比较容易啊。
Because it is easier to cure us of our physical suffering.
只要一句话就可以。
Just one word will do it.
就好像对这个三十八年的瘸子一样。
Just like this sick person for 38 years.
起来，拿着你的褥子回家吧。
All he said was, "Rise, take your bed and walk."
很简单。
Very easy.
但是要解决人灵魂的痛苦就没有那么简单了。
But to relieve us of our sufferings in our soul, it is more difficult.
因为肉体的痛苦是暂时的。
Because the physical suffering is temporary.
而灵魂的痛苦是永远的。
But the suffering of the soul is eternal.
因此主耶稣必须要付出相当大的代价。
So Jesus had to make a very great sacrifice.
他必须为人背负罪担啊。
He needed to carry on the sin of the humans.
为人受尽痛苦。
To suffer for humans.
流出宝血。
To shed his blood.
最后为人代死。
At the end, to die for them.
这样才能够让我们得到真正的平安。
This is the only way we can receive true peace.
那这是一件相当痛苦的事情。
This is a very difficult thing.
但是主耶稣为了解决我们的痛苦，他甘愿为我们承担这一切哦。
But because Jesus was willing to relieve us of our sufferings, he was willing to do this for us.
你会问说为什么？
You may ask why.
不为什么。
There's no reason why.
只因为他了解我们的痛苦。
It is only because he knows our suffering.
只因为他了解我们的需要。
Only because he knows our needs.
只因为他真的是爱我们每一位啊。
Only because he truly loves each and every one of us.
所以他就这样怜悯了我们。
And that is why he had mercy on us.
主耶稣要用他最大的怜悯来建设一个真正的怜悯之家。
And he uses his greatest mercy to establish the true house of mercy.
那不是必士大慈。
That is not the pool of Bethesda.
就是我们今天的正教会。
It is the true church of today.
在2001年3月份的圣灵月刊里面。
In the Holy Spirit Monthly of the March 2011 article.
有一篇文章很好。
There was an article that was very good.
它的题目是，他不重，他是我的兄弟啊。
And the article's title was that he is not heavy, he is my brother.
据说在我们美国有两个小孩子哦。
We hear that in the United States there's two small children.
是一对兄弟啊。
They are brothers.
很不幸他的父母很早就去世了。
And it is unfortunate that the parents passed away at a young age.
所以两个兄弟很可怜，到处流浪。
So the two brothers have been wandering around.
后来他们真的没有办法生活下去了。
And in the end they could no longer live on their own.
他们想到最后一条路就是到孤儿院去了。
So they thought that the last resort was to go to an orphanage.
可是要到孤儿院路途相当遥远啊。
But the path to the orphanage is long.
他们没有钱坐车啊。
They have no money for transportation.
只好用两条腿走路去啊。
So they only use their legs to walk.
这一路上两个小孩子又饥又渴。
And on the journey, these two children were thirsty and hungry.
最后这个弟弟实在是走不动了。
And in the end, the brother could no longer walk further.
怎么办呢？
So what did they do?
于是这个哥哥就背着弟弟走。
So the older brother carried his younger brother on him.
很辛苦哦。
This is very difficult.
最后一直走到孤儿院的门口。
At the end, they walked to the door of the orphanage.
当时在孤儿院有一位神父看到了。
And at that time, there was a priest at the orphanage that saw this.
赶紧跑出来。
And he hurried out.
然后帮这个哥哥把弟弟抱起来。
He helped the brother lift the younger brother.
这个神父一抱起弟弟来，他说了一句话。
When he lifted the younger brother, he said,
他一定很重嘞。
He said, wow, this This, your brother must be heavy.
是的，这个弟弟很重。
It is true, his brother was very heavy.
尤其要背着他走这么长的路途，很重。
Especially to carry him on such a far journey.
但是没有想到，这个哥哥却回答说他不重哎。
But not to realize that the brother, older brother, actually responded by saying he is not heavy.
为什么
？Why is this?
因为他是我的兄弟呀。
Because he is my brother.
哇，这件事感动很多的人。
So this.This fact, this situation moved many people.
那后来听说有一位作曲家特别写了一首诗啊。
And then we heard that later on, a psalmist wrote a song for this.
然后谱唱曲，那个曲名就叫做《他不重，他是我的兄弟》啊。
And the title of it was called "He is not heavy, he is my brother."
后来听说在1970年代越战的期间。
And then later on, it was heard that in 1970, around the time of the Vietnam War,
啊，有一个作家又写了一个故事了。
There was another author who wrote a story.
说在当时有一个黑人士兵，他是基督徒。
That there was a African soldier that was a Christian.
那他在新兵训练的时候，常常被一位白人士兵欺负。
And when he was in training, he was often made fun of or had trouble from white soldiers.
但是他都不计较。
But he did not complain.
后来两个人都被派到战场上了。
And then later on, the two of them were sent out to the battlefield.
啊，有一次这个白人士兵受伤。
And this one time, this Caucasian soldier was wounded.
这个黑人士兵看到。
And this black soldier saw.
啊，他不顾危险的跑去救他。
And he just ran.Toward him to try to save and help him.
然后把他背起来
and carried him.
拼命地跑
and ran.
跑了一段很长的丛林路哦
and ran a far way through the jungle.
虽然这一段路非常危险又很难跑
although the path was hard and it was difficult to tread.
但是这位黑人士兵就这样背着他跑过去
but this black soldier carried the other soldier on his back and ran.
一直跑回到安全的地方
ran up to the safe ground.
当时有人在问他
And at that time, someone asked,
哇，你的朋友应该很重吧
Wow, your friend must be heavy.
没有想到这位黑人士兵他这么回答
But this black soldier responded,
他不重的
He's not heavy.
为什么
Why is this?
因为他是我的兄弟啊
Because he is my brother.
啊，这件事后来被报道出来了
And this came out in a report later on.
也感动很多的人啊
It also touched the heart of many.
于是写这篇文章的是我们教会的姐妹。
And the person that wrote this article is actually one of our church sisters.
她觉得这个精神是对的。
And she believed that the spirit is true, is correct.
所以她就用这种精神来教她只有四岁的儿子。
And this is the attitude she had when she was teaching her four-year-old child.
她告诉自己的孩子哦。
She told her child.
哎，凡是你遇到大人，都要称他阿姨啊、叔叔啊、伯伯啊。
That when you see an adult, you must greet them either uncle or auntie.
啊，如果遇到小孩子比你大的，就是你的哥哥哦。
And if you see other children that are older than you, then they are your brothers.
啊，就是你的姐姐哦。
They are your sisters.
啊，如果遇到比你小的，那就是你的弟弟，就是你的妹妹啊。
And if you see younger children, then they are your younger sisters and your younger brothers.
啊，他的儿子非常听话。
And her son was very obedient.
啊，有一天他们到一个朋友家里去玩了。
One day they went to a friend's house.
他这个朋友是不是我们教会的
？And this friend was not a church member.
啊，他朋友家里面有三个小孩子。
And the friend had three children.
有两个比这位姐妹的孩子大。
Two of them were bigger and older than the other little child.
那有一个比这位姐妹的孩子小。
And there was one that was younger than the sister's child.
啊，总共加起来四个孩子。
So in total, there were four children.
啊，四个小孩子就玩在一起，很高兴。
So the four children played together.
但你知道孩子在玩没多久就吵架了。
But after a while, they started to argue.
啊，这位姐妹的孩子就哭着来告诉妈妈。
And the sister's son came running to tell his mom.
说妈妈，哥哥不让我玩玩具啊。
And he was crying and he said, Mom, my older brother would not let me play.
哎，只给他们真正的弟弟玩。
And only gave the toys to his true brother.
我也是他真的弟弟啊。
But I am also his brother.
为什么他们说我不是他们的弟弟呢
？Why did they tell me I'm not their brother?
这个时候我们叫这个姐妹愣住了。
And at this time, the sister in our church was stunned.
她心想，大概我教错了吧。
And she thought to herself, maybe I taught him incorrectly.
现在是什么时代啊？
What kind of society are we in?
现在是什么社会啊？
What kind of time are we in?
或许我不应该这样教他的。
Maybe I shouldn't have taught him this way.
我是不是要该要教他怎么样来保护自己才行啊？
Maybe I should teach him how to defend himself.
正在想的时候，
As while she was thinking this,
突然之间，他朋友的那个最小的小弟弟跌倒了。
All of a sudden, the youngest little brother of her friend's children fell.
当然跌倒就在哭了。
And of course, the little boy was crying.
可是他的两个哥哥只顾玩玩具，没理他。
But the little child's older two brothers only cared about playing and did not pay attention to him.
这个时候，这位姐妹的孩子只有四岁哦。
And at this time, the sister's child, who was only four,
却一面擦眼泪，一面跑过去啊。
Wiped his tears away and ran toward the little boy.
啊，这位姐妹看到就赶紧问他说：“你要做什么？”
And the sister hurried and saw him doing this and asked, "What are you doing?"
哎，他的孩子哦，只有四岁哦，边跑边说：“他是我弟弟，他需要帮忙啊。”
And her child, who was running and running and crying and wiping his tears at the same time, said that he's my brother. I have to help him.
这位姐妹跟她的孩子说：“小弟弟太重了，你抱不了的。”
And then the sister said to her child, "This little brother is too heavy for you. You won't be able to lift him."
啊，妈妈帮你把他抱起来了。
And mommy will help you lift him.
没想到她的孩子竟然回答。
But not to think, the child actually answered.
他不重的。
He's not heavy.
我可以抱他。
I can carry him.
因为他是我的弟弟啊。
Because he's my brother.
啊，这时候这位姐妹心里面豁然开朗了。
And then at this time, particular moment, the sister actually realized.
啊，满心感谢神。
And was grateful and thankful to God.
她告诉自己的孩子说。
She told her own child.
你做得很对啊。
You are doing a good thing.
神就是喜欢我们这样来帮助人的。
Because God wants us to help others in this way.
因为我们的主就是满心怜悯、大有慈悲的主。
Because our Lord is full of compassion and full of love.
今天主耶稣也是希望凡是得到他的怜悯的人，也能够用这种怜悯的心肠去怜悯别人。
And the same way, Jesus hopes that all those who received mercy from him can also show mercy to others.
然后用这种怜悯的心肠来建立一个真正的怜悯之家。
And with this merciful heart, we can establish a true house of mercy.
那就是神的真教会。
That is the true church of God.
因为教会就是主的身体。
Because the church is the body of God.
最后我们来看雅各书。
Let's lastly turn to the book of James.
雅各书的第二章。
James chapter 2.
请看第十三节。
Let's read verse 13.
雅各书第二章第十三节。
James chapter 2 verse 13.
雅各书二章十三节。
James 2:13.
因为那不怜悯人的也要受无怜悯的审判，怜悯原是向审判夸胜。
For judgment is without mercy to the one who has shown no mercy. Mercy triumphs over judgment.
今天很感谢主啊。
Today I thank God.
今天我们都来到真正的怜悯之家。
That we are able to come to this true house of mercy,
也就是神的教会啊
which is also the church of God.
我们都得到主耶稣最大的怜悯啊
We have all received the Lord's greatest mercy.
主耶稣不只解决我们肉体的痛苦
Not only did he allow us to not suffer any longer physically,
更白白医治了我们灵魂的疾病啊
but also cured of our sickness to the soul,
让我们能够脱离罪恶
so that we can,
让我们能够不致死亡
so that we will not go toward the path of death,
让我们成为一个有活泼盼望的新人
so that we can become a new person with hope,
就像那三十八年的瘸子一样
just like the lamed that was lame for 38 years.
那主耶稣这样做的目的是为什么呢
what is the purpose of Jesus doing this?
主耶稣除了要怜悯我们以外
Not only does he want to have mercy on us.
主耶稣除了要救我们以外
，aside from just saving us，
主耶稣也希望我们能用这种心肠去怜悯别人，去救别人啊。
Jesus hopes that we use the same heart to have compassion on other people.
因此，我们今天一方面要赶快传福音哦。
So today we really should try to preach the gospel.
要赶快抢救灵魂啊。
To hurry to try to save some souls.
另一方面，我们要赶快关心主内的弟兄姐妹。
And we should really try to show concern and care for other brothers and sisters.
尤其是那些生了病迷失的羊啊。
Especially to those who are ill or those who are lost.
我们真的需要彼此的扶持啊。
We really should try to do this to everyone.
我们真的需要互相的照顾。
We need to care for everyone.
我们真的需要让我们的教会成为真正的怜悯之家。
We need to have our church become the true house of mercy.
来荣耀主的名啊。
So that we can glorify the name of God.
但是问题是，我们今天真的做到了吗
？But the question is, have we all done this?
好，记得。十几年前，多明尼加有一位弟兄到阿根廷去受训。
I remember about a decade or so ago, there was a brother who went to Dominican Republic to train.
啊，有一天我们带他去坐地下铁。
And one day we took him onto the underground subway system.
回来的以后，他告诉我一件事情。
When we returned, he told me one thing.
他说一上地下铁，他在想什么？
He told me when he got on the train, what was he thinking?
那一般我们在地下铁会想到什么
？What is it that we usually think of when we're on the subways?
大概想说，等一下我去哪里呀、啊、
？We might be thinking later we will go to this place or that place.
买什么东西呀、啊、
？Or we will buy something.
或者到哪里去逛一逛、啊、
？Or we will go visit some areas.
他说他一上地下铁什么都不想。
But he told me when he got on the train, he did not think of anything.
他只想一件事。
He only thought of one thing.
他觉得坐在车这个。啊，地下铁车上的人很可怜哦。
He thought the people riding the subway system was very pitiful.
哦，这些人像圣经所说的，正坐在死荫的幽谷当中。
Because these people are just like what the Bible says, they are in the valley of death.
他们的灵魂生病了。
Because their souls are sick.
他们属灵的腿瘸掉了。
Their spiritual legs are crippled.
他们没有盼望的。
They have no hope.
所以，他只有一个感觉。
So he only had a feeling.
如果现在手上我有传单，马上一个一个发给他们。
He thought to himself, if he had flyers on him at hand, he would give the flyers to them and hand them out one at a time.
今天我们对没有信主的人有这样的感受吗
？Today, do we have the same feeling toward those who are non-believers?
尤其当我们看到有软弱的弟兄姐妹迷失了，请问我们着急吗？
Especially toward the brothers and sisters who are lost or weak, are we worried for them?
还是只认为这是传道负责人是跟我无关？
Or do we think to ourselves that that is not my problem, that is the problem of the pastors and the board members?
这是我们必须要好好反省的。
This is something we really should reflect on.
那当然，这个怜悯人的过程是艰辛的。
But of course, the process of being merciful.
不管是传福音。或者是牧养教会、关心信徒，这种工作是繁重的。
Not only is it a heavy duty to preach the gospel or to care for members.
但是求主耶稣帮助我们。
But we ask God to help us.
只要我们能够具有像主耶稣那一种的怜悯的心肠。
As long as we have the same kind of mercy that Jesus possessed.
我们就会觉得这些工作不重的。
Then we will realize that these tasks are not heavy.
为什么？
Why is that?
因为他们也是我们的弟兄姐妹啊。
Because they too are our brothers and sisters.
所以求神帮助我们。
So let's ask God to help us.
让我们都有怜悯之心。
So that all of us have a merciful heart.
这样将来在审判台前，我们才能够向审判夸胜的。
So that in front of the judgment at the end, we will be able to boast about it.
也就是说，我们才不会受到那个没有怜悯的审判，那是很可怕的啊。
So that we will not be judged on a judgment without mercy, and that is very fearful.
我想这是我们从这个神迹所一起学习的道理。
I believe this is the gospel and the lesson that we can learn from this particular miracle.
啊，但愿我们能够明白这些道理。
And I hope that all of us can understand this teaching.
而且能够努力地去遵行。
So that we can strive to try to follow it.
让我们的教会，不管在哪一个地方的真教会，都能够成为真正的怜悯之家。
So that our church, regardless of the location of our church, can all become the true house of mercy.
啊，愿神祝福大家。
May the Lord bless every one of us.
也愿神的恩惠常与大家同在。
And may the blessings and grace be amongst us.
Amen.
Amen.